Hello my dear students, how are you? I hope you are fine at your home. Today we are going to see a new topic, that is whole numbers. It is very interesting topic and also an easy topic. Okay. Before going to know the whole numbers, we have to know what is mean by natural numbers first. See here, look at the whole natural numbers. What is mean by natural number? If someone asks you to count the things, means how do you count? 1, 2, 3, 4, like that you will count. Such numbers are called natural numbers. That is 1, 2, 3, etc. 3, 4, 5, 6. It was going on like that. 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. are called natural numbers. The natural number also called as counting numbers. It is also called as counting numbers because we are using this number to count the things. So we call it as counting numbers. Okay. So whenever the question asks you what is mean by natural number, means you have to say 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. are called natural numbers. In the etc. it contains infinity numbers. Okay. It has countless numbers. It is 5, 10, like that. It is going on 10,000, lakh, million, billion, billion, etc. Included all these numbers. So 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. are called natural numbers. And symbol for natural number is capital N. Okay. Next we are going to see whole number. What is mean by whole number? Is along with the natural number we are including one number. That number is 0. Thus 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. are called whole numbers. The only difference between natural number and whole number is nothing but 0. In natural number we are starting 1. In whole number you are starting with 0. Thus 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. are called whole numbers. Whole number also starts from 0 and it also ends. Okay. And my question is, what is the smallest natural number? Yes, smallest natural number is 1. And which is the smallest whole number? Smallest whole number is 0. It's great. In this topic, what we are going to see is successor and predecessor. In the primary class, you have the successor and the predecessor. And in the 6th standard, you have the higher digit of number you have to find. What is mean by successor? Successor means after number. How do you find the after number? By adding 1 to a given number, we can easily find the successor. And what is mean by predecessor? Predecessor means previous number. How can we find it? By subtracting 1 to the given number, we can easily find. See here children, this is the number 3. What is the before number 2? 3, 2. So 2 is called predecessor of 3. And what is the after number 2, 3, 4? So 4 is called successor. So how can you find the successor? By adding 1 with 3, you get 4. It is successor. By subtracting 1 with 3, you get 2. That is called predecessor. We can also say the successor as next number. And we can also say the predecessor as previous number. Okay. See here, we are going to do one sum. Example 1. Write the predecessor of, see the first one. How can you read this number? Here the commas are placed in by using the Indian system of numeration. So 1 stands 100,000, 10,000 lakh, 10 lakh, that is 68 lakh, 4,500. Similarly, 5,89,999. For this given number, you have to find the predecessor. Predecessor means previous number. To find it, you have to subtract 1 from the given number. See here, so we are finding predecessor. So this is the first one, 6,804,500 minus 1. If you minus 1 from this number, you get 68,4,499. If you know the answer without calculation, you can write the answer directly. Otherwise, you have to do the rough work like this. See here, 6,804,500. You have to write the 1 in the 1's place. That is last. Last place. That is, you have to write the 1 straight to 0. And then you have to do the subtraction. You can find the answer. You have to write this answer as the predecessor. See the next one, 5,89,999. If you subtract 1, you can easily 9 minus 1, you can easily write the answer 998. Suppose if you don't know the answer, means you do the calculation for your effort, and then you can easily find the answer and write this final answer as the predecessor. It's clear to them. See the next one. Next we are going to find the successor. Read the question, write the successor of ASM 23,50,700. B question, 1, 10, 100, 1,000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, and then crore. That is 3 crore, 21 lakhs, 909. And see the third one, 89,999. For these three sums, we are going to find the successor now. Successor means what are you going to do? You have to add one number with the given number. So write the given number and add one. What you get? 23, 50 and 701. Similarly, see here 3, 21, 0, 0, 909 plus 1. If you add 1 with this 909, you get 910. See here, children. Here your answer is 910. Okay? See the next one. 89,999 plus 1. If you add 1 with C here, of course. 89,999, write the 1 in the last place. 9 plus 1, 10, remainder 1, 10, remainder 1, 10, remainder 1, 10, you get lastly 90,000 as your answer. See the rough for the second B sum. 3, 2, 1, 0, 0, 909, you are adding 1 with that, you get 910 as I wrote. Okay, that's all about the successor children. Next we are going to do is we are going to represent the whole number in the number line. Okay. Before going to represent the whole number, we have to recall some concept. That is, what is meant by line, ray, line segment. Okay, see here, this is the diagrammatic representation of line. Line means it has no endpoints. No endpoints. No endpoints. No endpoints in the external on both direction. We understand, children? Line means it has no endpoints in the external on both direction. And what is the ray? Ray is a part of a line and it has one endpoint. One endpoint. It has only one endpoint. This is the endpoint and it external on other direction. It's clear, children? Line has no endpoints. Ray is a part of a line, it has one endpoint and it extends on other direction. Okay. And see the next one, line segment. What is the line segment? Line segment, it is also the part of line. It has two endpoints. See this here, it has two endpoints. This is also the example for line segment. Thus, line segment has two endpoints. And ray has only one endpoint and line has no endpoints. Why we are seeing this is, on representing the whole number on the number line, we have to choose line or ray or line segment. So what we have to choose? Automatically we have to choose ray only because whole number start with 0 and it has no end. So we are choosing ray to represent the whole number. But though we are using ray, we are always saying number line only. Okay? Thus, I have drawn the ray and represent the number like this. First, you have to write 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 like this. And this is called the left hand side of the number line. And this side is called the right hand side of the number line. See here, I am choosing the number 4, 5. And right hand side of the 5, I have 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And left hand side of the 5, I have 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. Like this, you have to say. Do you understand how to draw the number line? You have to just use scale and use the sharpened pencil. First use scale and draw the line. And then here you have to draw a line like this. Here you have to write 0 and then 1, 2, 3. For this measurement it should be equal. So you can take 1 centimeter as a unit. So it should be equal. For that I am saying you can take 1 centimeter as a distance between the two numbers. Next we are going to do the sum from exercise 2.1. See the 10th sum. Perform the following operations on a number line. Now what we are going to do is, you are already know addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. Now we are going to do these operations on the number line now. Okay. See here, you already know what is the answer for 2 plus 5 is. It is very easy, 7. But we are going to do this addition in the number line. Okay. See here. First step is you have to draw the number line like this and write the numbers by keeping the distance 1 centimeter between the two numbers. Okay. This is the first step. Okay. This is the left hand side and this is the right hand side. What is the operation here? Addition. What is the first number here? 2. So choose the number 2 first. Addition means you have to move on to the right hand side of the number line. So first you are moving 1 unit first. Here they give the 5. So you have to move 5 times each unit. Okay. First you are moving from 2 to 3 and then 4 and then 5 while moving on left hand side, the arrow will change. Okay, so you get this 2 to 3, 3 to 4, 5, 6, 7. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 times you have to draw the arc because here they give the 5. So finally, where you have reached? You have reached the number 7. Here you have to write, that is above the number, and you have to write 2 plus 5 equal to 7. See the next sum. 8 minus 3. Here the operation is addition. Here the operation is subtraction. In the addition, we move towards the right. While in the case of subtraction, we have moved towards the left. See here. First, you have to go to the number 8 first. So, you have the 8 and put your point here. After that, you have to move how many units? 3 units. So, 1, 2, 3. Further, you have to put the arrow like this, arc like this, and arrow like this. This page number. So, finally, 1, 2, 3. We have moved the 3 units, and finally, we reach the number 5. And above the number line, you have to write it as 8 minus 3 equal to 5. For all this purpose, you have to use pencil only. Don't use pen. Stay children. Next, see the submission is now. What is the question? 3 into 4. That is, we have to represent this multiplication of the number line. See here children, listen this sum carefully. First step is, you have to draw the number line. You can write the number as much as possible. It may be 15, again 16, like that you have to write. Okay. Next step is, first you have to choose, see the number, what is first you want. 3 into 4, and 3 should be the units you have to move. 3 units, and this is the times. 4 times you have to go into move here. That is, first you have to place your pencil on 0 in the process of multiplication. First you have to place your pencil here. First you have to move here, a jump you are going to do here. That is, you are not going by unit by unit. First you have to move 3 units. Okay. So you are going to jump from 0 to 3. So you have to draw an arc from 0 to 3 and put the arc like this because you are going to right. And next jump also 3 units, and from 3, 3 units is 1, 2, 3. So you have to draw an arc from 3 to 6 and put the arrow like this. Here. Next jump is 3 units and from 6. So 1, 2, 3 units. So finally you have to reach 9. So you have to draw the arc like this and put the arrow once. So how many times you have to make this jump? 4 times. 1, 2, 3 times we have completed. So this is the last jump from 9. 3 units. 1, 2, 3 units from 9. 1, 2, 3. You have to draw the arc like this and put the arrow once. Finally we have reached which number? 12. Thus here we have to write 3 into 4 equal to 12. For the process of multiplication, you have to move on the right words. Okay. See the next one. 2 into 4. How many units you have to move? 2 units. How many times? 4 times. So you have to start from 0. Your first sum 0 to 2. This is the first jump. And after the 2 units is 1, 2. Up to move that from 2 to 4. After that you have to move 2 units from 4, that is 4 to 6, and then 2 units 6 to 8. Count the jumps 1, 2, 3, 4. Here also they gave 4. Thus you have to move 2 units from 4 times. Finally you reach 8. Thus your answer is 2 into 4. 2 into 4 equal to 8. You have to write on the above the number line. See the next one. This is, these two sums are multiplication sum. We are moving the, we are drawing the arc on the towards the right hand side. This is division sum. Here we are draw the arc towards the left hand side. See the first sum. I division 12 divided by 3. That is, you have to divide the 12 by 3. You know the answer 4 already. But you have to draw this division on the number line. What is the first number? 12. Here first you have to go to the number 12 first. After that, you have to move, you have to take the jump for how many units? 3 units. Suppose here you have 4 means 4 units, 5 means 5 units, like that you have to make the jump. That is, make the draw the arc for 3 units. Here we have 3, so you have to draw the arc for 3 units from 12. That is, take 11. Before 12, you have to count 1, 2, 3. That is, you have to draw the arc from 12 to 9, first arc. And then you have to count 3 units. 1, 2, 3 before 9. So you have to draw the arc from 9 to 8. First, you are in 12. Before that, after that you have to come to 9. After that you have to come to 6. After before 3 units or 6 is 1, 2, 3. You have to draw up for say 3. You have to draw up here. How many jumps you have to make is until you reach 0, you have to draw the arc like this. For multiplication, you are drawing the arcs for distance 4 times, 4 times here. Suppose here they give 5 means 5 times you have to draw the arc. But in the process of division, until you reach the 0, you have to draw the arc like this. Okay? Thus, I reach the 3 here. Before 3 units, I reach the 0. Until you reach the 0, you have to draw the arc like this. Okay? Finally, how can you write the answer like this? See here, how many arcs you have drawn? 1, 2, 3, 4. Thus, 12 divided by 3 is equal to 4. This is your final answer. First step is you have to place your pencil in the 12. After that you have to move draw the arc for 3 units. 1. After that you have to again you have 3. So the second arc, third arc, 4 arc. Until you reach 0 you have to draw the arcs. Finally you have to count the arcs. How many arcs you have drawn? 1, 2, 3, 4. That is your answer. 12 divided by 3 equal to 4. Stay children. That's all the number line. See the next one. Represent the following whole numbers on the number line. This is the A sum and B sum is your homework. That is you have to just draw the number line. And what they are asking, represent the number 4, 7, 9. So draw the number line and mark the lines and write the numbers. And highlight the number 4, 7, 9 by using the pencil and circle the number. That's all the this sum. Okay. See the next one. In the following pair of numbers, see the first one. Question number, subdivision A. Identify the number to the right of the other on the number line. See here, take this line. Before seeing the sum, I give you one example. Take this number 9. Choose the number 9. Which is the right hand side of the number 9? Yes, 10. This is the right hand side of number 9. And which number is the left hand side of number 9? 8. This is the left hand side of number 9. Similarly, they are asking, they are giving two numbers. See here. 4783. First station is your homework. This is second station. 4783 and 4774. Suppose if you mark this number on the number line, first you write the smaller number first. 4774 and then 4775. Like this you write 75, 76, 78 and then 80, 81, 82. Last you will write 4783. Now observe this number line carefully. What is the question they are asking? Identify the number to the right of the other number line. They give only two numbers. One is 4774 and another number is 4783. Which number is on the right hand side? Observe the line. Which is on the right hand side? In this number line, this is right hand side and this is left hand side. By seeing this, you can easily say this number is on the right hand side of this number. So you can simply write 4783 is on right. Okay. I give a hint to you. If the question given like this means among the two numbers, choose the bigger number. It should be on the right hand side. See here, this is the given question. 774, here 783. Among this number, which is the bigger one? 783. So easily you can write 4783 is on the right. It's clear to them. Suppose in the question if they ask which is on the left, it means you have to write the smaller one. It's clear. See the next one. The B question is simply left hand side only. See the question. Identify the number to the left of the other number on a number line. Okay. This is subdivision 1 and subdivision 2 is your homework. What is the first question? How can you read this number? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 0 means it is 1,99,999. I have already told, if the right hand side means you have to say the big number and left hand side means you have to say the smaller number. So obviously you can say 99,999 is on the left hand side of the number line. See the next one. How many whole numbers are there between first question 42 and 57, second question 342 and 352? In the chapter 1 number itself, we have did the same model sum more than 3, I think. Okay, you are already thorough this model. Though you are thorough, I have put the solution for this sum. The first step you have to do the between sum means I did the second sum, first sum is over for you. The first step is you have to write the given numbers and then you have to subtract the smaller number from the larger number. What is your answer? 10. This 10 includes the 352. But the question is, suppose the question like this 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 means between they are asking what are the between numbers 2 and 6 means we have to exclude the 2 and 6. We have to say 3, 4, 5 are the between numbers 2 and 6. Like that they are asking you have to find the how many numbers are between 342 and 352. Between 2 and 6 how many numbers? 1, 2, 3 numbers. Similarly you have to say that how many numbers between 342 and 352. First step is you have to subtract the smaller number from the larger number. You get the answer 10. This 10 includes the 352. In order to exclude this 352 you have to subtract 1 from 10. You get 10 minus 1 equal to 9. Thus between 342 and 352 you write the numbers and count to them, you can definitely find 9 numbers between 342 and 352. Similarly you have to do this sum 42 and 57. Okay, see the next one. This is one mark sum. Write if possible the largest whole number. What they are asking is you have to write the largest whole number. We have already seen in the definition of whole number it is endless. So how can you find the larger number from the endless number? So you have to write not possible. See the next question. How many whole numbers are there? They are asking only there are how many whole numbers. Now only I can say it is endless. So you have to write it as countless or infinity numbers. Okay. You have write countless as the answer. Clear children? Let's see the fifth sub-problem, exercise 2.1 children. Is it true that every whole number has a successor? What is this? Is the one more question. Okay, what is they are asking is every whole number is having successor number. This is the whole number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. What is the successor of 0, 1? What is the successor of 3, 4? Like that, we can easily find successor of every number. So you have to write the answer is yes or no. Okay, what is the next one? Every whole number has a predecessor. The question is every whole number has a predecessor. Predecessor means previous number. What is the predecessor of 4? 3. What is the predecessor of 2? What is the predecessor of 0? No, nothing is here. So here you have to write no. 0 does not have a predecessor. Please see children. See the next one. 4th sum from your exercise 2.1. Write the 3 whole numbers immediately preceding and the 3 whole numbers immediately succeeding. That is, before going to this sum, see this example children. What is given in the question is, see this example. I have done 1 to 9, round the number 5. What is the 3 number before 2, 5? 4, 3, 2. These 3 numbers are called as 3 whole number immediately preceding 5. Preceding means before number. Do you understand children? And 6, 7, 8. 6, 7, 8 are called as 3 whole numbers immediately succeeding. Do you understand the question children? This is the question they are asked. Instead of 5, you have this number. Do you understand? Write the 3 whole numbers immediately preceding and immediately succeeding means for the given number you have to write the 3 numbers before 2 it and 3 numbers after 2 it. See this number, how can you read this? 1, 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, lakh, 10 lakh, crore, 10 crore, 99 crore, 88 lakhs, 899. Before the 899, you have to choose 99 alone. What is that before number to 99? 98. Before to 98? 97. Before that 96. Thus we have written 99 crores, 88 lakhs, 896 and here 897 and 898. These are the 3 numbers preceding the given whole number, which is the given whole number. 99 crores, 88 lakhs, 899. These are the 3 numbers preceding to the given number. And next we have to write the succeeding 3 whole numbers. Succeeding 3 whole numbers means we have to write the after number. What is the last digit in the given number? 899. So what is the after number for 899? So you have to write here 900 and 901 and 902. If you are not able to find this number means you just add 1 to the given number. You have to do it in the rough work. You have to write the 1 here and do the calculation in your rough work and then find the next number like this. If you don't answer me, straightly write the answer. Okay. These three are the succeeding three whole numbers, and these three are the preceding whole number of the given number. And see here, this is the first sum and summation. See, is every whole number is a natural number? What they are asking is, every natural number is a, sorry, every whole number is a natural number. They are asking. We know 1, 2, 3, etc. are natural number. And 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. are whole number. See here, children, one is a, this is whole number, and this is natural number. Here, one is the whole number, here it becomes a natural number. But 0 is not in natural number. So we can say no. That is, every whole number is not a natural number, because in natural number it did not have 0. Okay, this is your homework, children. In example 3, they have asked to write the predecessor of 1 million. How can you write the 1 million? You know the place value. 1, 10, 100,000, 10,000, 100,000 million, 10 million, 100 million. To write the number 1 million, you have to choose the number million place. This is the 1 million place. So I write 1 here and add 0 to the remaining place. This is the 1 million. To find the predecessor of the 1 million, you have to subtract 1 from this number, you can get the predecessor. This is your homework sum. Similarly, you have to write the predecessor of 1 lakh. This is your example 4. Further, you have to write, if you know the 1 lakh means, write the 1 lakh as it is. Those who don't know to write the 1 lakh, further, you have to write the place value as in the Indian system, and then choose the place value lakh. Write the 1 instead to the place value and add 0 to the remaining places, you get 1 lakh. Similarly, you can find 10 lakh, crore, 10 crore like that. Okay? In the question, they are asking predecessor or successor. I think it is successor. I think successor means you have to add 1, and predecessor means you have to subtract 1. Okay, it's clear, children.
My dear students, we have already discussed about the real number system. Mainly, the real number systems are divided into two divisions. One is irrational numbers and another one is rational numbers. Inside the rational numbers, we are having integers, whole numbers and natural numbers. In today's class, we are discussing the chapter whole numbers. So, what is mean by whole numbers? Whole numbers start from 0. So, 0, 1, 2, 3, etc. are said to be whole numbers. See here, children, we are seeing the number line representation of whole numbers. We are using ray to represent the whole numbers. Why? Because ray have one endpoint and another endpoint extend endlessly. So we are using ray to represent the whole numbers. Similarly, whole number also having the starting point 0 and extends in another direction endlessly. See the number line, it starts from 0. So 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. So these numbers are said to be whole numbers. And we are using the symbol capital W to represent the whole numbers. See here, children. What are you seeing? Whole numbers. Inside the whole number circle, you are seeing the natural numbers. We can use any shape to draw this whole numbers and natural numbers chart. Okay. See here, inside the whole numbers, we are having the natural numbers. It means if you add 0 with natural numbers, you get the whole numbers. What is the whole numbers? If you add 0 with natural numbers, you get whole numbers. See here, natural numbers start from 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. But the whole numbers start from 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. It means natural numbers along with 0 is said to be whole numbers. I hope you understand very clearly about the whole numbers. Thank you, children.